Okay, so when it comes to this Home NAS from QNAP, is it easy to navigate through the software? Is it easy to set up anything on this? What kind of features does it actually have? Does it have any good features for maybe a home user? Let's actually find that out in the review of the QNAP Home NAS. Okay, so this is what you're actually looking at. This is what the interface of the actual Home NAS looks like. It tells you everything about the overall drive. It allows you to set up the RAID, which at the moment I've set it up as RAID 1, but it does have a redundancy, which means that I'm only getting half of the capacity, which is only 6 terabytes at this present moment, but 6 terabytes is fine for the moment. Now, what I'm going to show you here is the App Center, because believe it or not, all of this is included when you buy one of these Home NASs from QNAP, which is quite impressive because it has a lot of different applications. Now, what I'm going to show you here is my apps. This is all the apps I've got installed. That's it. 19 apps, that's all I've got installed. But this thing has so much now when it comes to backup and sync. I haven't touched any of that because I'm still getting used to the software myself, but it has everything you just need. Content management, it has communications, it has developer tools if you're a developer, then of course you can use this. The download station, that is where you can download all your backup software videos, photos, stuff like that. Then it's got entertainment, where you can actually set it up as a Plex server, like something similar to Linus Tech Tips, except this is a Home NAS where he made his own NAS himself. And then you've got surveillance, where this will be actually good for if you've got cameras, security cameras around your house. This, you can have these sync up to those. As long as you leave the NAS on continuously, it should be able to record as well as back up all the surveillance that you need for the cameras. Now, utilities, this is where this starts getting a bit bonkers. Now, for the money, all of this is included. It's ridiculous. It has every single thing you need. Okay, so file station, that is where I choose to set up and obviously send over my files. You can do it in other ways, but I find it easier going in through the interface because I'm actually starting to get used to it. Once you get used to the interface, it's easier to navigate around. But they've got so much in this, it's absolutely incredible. Now, resource monitor is probably a good one because this will show you everything. It'll show you the CPU usage. It'll also tell you how much memory you're using. It'll also tell you the network usage. Now, storage resource, this is where it's going to be quite interesting. It's going to tell you the individual RAID and it'll tell you the disk activity. Now, as you can see by here, I'm actually reading these. That is the NVMEs I've got. I've got two. I got one that's Apacer, and then the other then is a 500 gig from Kingston. I put that in so I could use that for the OS and then have the Apacer for a cache, because if you cache it, then you're going to get better reads and writes. And also, hopefully, it should be a lot better. This is the processes. But there's something I really want to show you. Now, when it comes to performance, it's quite easy to say, you know, it does this, it does that. But this is where it actually tells you what the performance is like. So, if you look by here, that it's got the reads, and then it's got the IOPS read results. Now, it tells you how fast, as well as how fast and how good the overall drives are. Now, yes, these are NAS specific hard drives. They're not going to be the fastest on the market, but these are all about reliability, which, to be honest, Toshiba has been doing this a very long time, as well as Apacer. And so far, I'm very happy with the overall performance I'm getting. I can upload, or I can transfer over 400 gig in about 55 minutes, which 400 gigabytes, that's quite a lot of data. I've got more than that back that needs to be backed up, but I'm gonna back it up, do it bit by bit, so I haven't got to back it up all at once, so it doesn't hog up all the resources of the Home NAS that I'm currently using. So safe to say, if you buy a QNAP Home NAS and buy the correct drives for it, you will actually be fine. Okay, so this is the performance testing. Now, when it comes to read and writes, hard drives, of course, they're going to start showing their age. But for my use case, because I use RAID, as well as I have the half of the storage I've got, 6 terabytes, into redundancy, I'm not so much worried about losing data, because the way I've set it up is it snapshots my data, so it saves what I've actually uploaded. Now, the speeds, you know, it's 112 megabytes. That's not the fastest by modern standards, but what I will say, that isn't bad. Now, if you can see from my internet connection, I've about 1 gig. Now, that's because I pay for it monthly, but it's important to me, and at the end of the day, the way I see it is I need it for uploading videos and downloading that I need, download games, stuff like that, that I need quickly and on demand to do videos. But look, this type of megabyte range isn't for everyone, but at the end of the day, this is just fine for me, because I'm, like I said, I'm going to be transferring my data bit by bit. I don't want it all on here at the moment, because I don't want to put all of it on one backup source. I want to do it bit by bit so then I can move things around. First of all, it's going to be primarily my backup on the computer. So for modern standards, no, it's not the fastest, but it works just fine for me. Okay, and guys, what did you think? Now, look, I'm not going to say that I am an expert when it comes to NAS or server type equipment. I am not. I'm a novice. I'm someone who's really just interested in this particular topic, and that I wanted to make videos of, because at the end of the day, it's something I personally want to learn more about. Now, the problem is, because it's a Home NAS, and as you saw through the video, this has so many features, it's quite hard to go through every single thing. But what I will tell you is that the drives that were provided by Toshiba, they were just plug and play instantly. And the NVMe drive from Apacer, that was also just plug and play. And also, the speeds, yes, aren't the fastest when it comes to today's technology. But for someone who doesn't back up every single day, I think those speeds are actually okay. From my standpoint, it's fine for me. Those speeds, they're fine. At the end of the day, I can plug this in, put it in the corner, transfer data over, and just do something else. It hasn't got to be me at the computer checking on it. That is the one of the best things I like about it. Yeah, it might take 45 minutes or to an hour to transfer 400 gigs, but 400 gigabyte of video files and images, that's a lot of data to transfer. And to be fair, this does it with no issues whatsoever. So it's easy to say, the QNAP Home NAS, very easy to set up, it's very easy to navigate once you get used to it. And what I will say is the overall interface, amazing, has so many different features, so many different functions. It's definitely good for a home user. You could set this up to be security for your cameras, a backup solution for that. You could set it up as a actual server for your media. You could set it up if you're a developer. You could set it up for just backing up your normal data from your computer, which that is what I wanted. I wanted something that's well-rounded, which I honestly think this is. Now, the Toshiba drives, they will be staying in this NAS permanently. They will stay there until they are completely full or I find a bigger solution for storage. At the moment, 6 terabytes is completely fine for me. So that's really fine. I don't go through a lot of storage that much, but obviously I've been doing this for years now when it comes to the YouTube videos, and they do start to stack up after a while. So yeah, what's the conclusion? If you want a Home NAS, QNAP is where to go. If you want an easy basically plug and play, then Toshiba drives, definitely easy, as well as the Apacer NVME. So I hope that answers your questions. I'd like to thank Toshiba, QNAP, as well as Apacer for sending out all this equipment, because I've thoroughly enjoyed potching with it and just trying to figure out how it works. So make sure you subscribe, because I have got so much stuff coming. I've got another case, I've got two more coolers and a set of connect fans. I've also got another set here. I've got thermal paste from the sister company, from Thermal Grizzly, to do. So make sure you subscribe, because I've got loads of stuff. And as always, I hope you guys have a fantastic weekend as well as the week ahead of you. This is Richard from Welshytech. Goodbye.